Hi guys, my name is Sunshine and I am blessed and honored to now be a part of the LUVV GOD community all the way from Rhode Island, USA. I'm currently in LA right now bringing you guys this video, and today I have the pleasure of starting a series that's going to talk about a lot of different topics that we as young believers dwell on. And in this episode, I'm going to be talking about dating and Christianity when it comes to dating slash courtship and marriage and finding love. I think that that's something we crave as believers. I think marriage is such a strong covenant that we as young believers, or just believers in general, want to be a part of. If we're not careful, we risk doing it wrong. And in this video, I'm going to briefly scratch the surface on ensuring that if you're pursuing dating, that it is according to the will of God. But I do know that a lot of the topics that will be talked about in this series, I know for a fact that these are a lot of the conversations that we have behind closed doors. So here I am. In this specific video, I'm going to be talking about dating and Christianity. In this video, I'm going to briefly talk about scratch the surface on dating according to the will of God. I think that this topic is so important to talk about, especially as we have new believers and young believers who were dating outside of Christianity and are now trying to navigate the proper way of dating according to the will of God. I think that a great basis to start is to define exactly what dating is. I think that as young people, the common term that we use is dating, but it is more deeper than that. And I think it's also very important to understand what courting actually really is, because truthfully, we are supposed to be courting and not dating. According to Merriam-Webster, dating and courting share the same definition, which is a series of social engagements shared by a couple looking to get married. Truthfully, that is what courting is and what dating should be. Although Merriam-Webster defined them to be the same, this world has separated the two. Dating within this world is without intention. Courting is with intention. Courting is engaging with someone in hopes of getting married in the near future. With dating, I think that in this world, a lot of us just are dating. Dating has no intention, no end goal, whether it's dating multiple people, whether it's just dating for fun, whether it's dating to get married. It's just a very vague. Hi, I just want to go back to the definitions, and I want to point out something that I'm hoping will give you guys a clear understanding of the difference between dating and courting. If you take a look at the sentence examples for dating, it says their dating had been going on for so long that she was starting to wonder if she'd ever take that trip down the aisle. And for courting, it says after 2 years of courting, they finally married. So you can obviously see a clear difference between the two. One's with intention, the other one isn't. With courting, there's a mutual agreement between the two that, hey, we're going to get to know each other and build a relationship, the foundation with God in the middle in hopes of us getting married. And I know courting can sometimes be foreign and not pleasing to the ear sometimes. It may be deemed as too serious, which it's not, but.
Hi guys, it's me again. I just want to clarify that courting definitely is too serious. I feel like the way I said it in this part can be really confusing, but courting is definitely serious. What I was trying to say was I believe that the term courting can overstimulate a lot of people, which leads them to thinking that it's more than it actually is. It's a very simple term, but it is very serious. I hope that makes sense.
So I believe that dating is definitely the will of God if it is being done right. A lot of us are dating without intention. We're dating according to the world. We need to be dating with more intention and more obedience to the will of God. But whether you want to use the term dating or whether you want to use the term courting, intentionality is the key.
Hi guys, I just want to chime in just one last time to clarify something else. As I'm editing this video, I'm realizing that I'm using both dating and courting a lot. I just want to clarify that if you hear me using dating, I'm using it detaching the definition of this world. So if I'm using dating, I'm using it in connection to courting, or basically saying that dating and courting mean the same thing, if that makes sense.
First way that I believe that a lot of us can be dating with more intention is, first off, being equally yoked. So I know the term equally yoked is pretty, it's pretty thrown out there a lot. But honestly, the simple definition of equally yoked is when you have the same morals and spiritual values as one another. So it's so important to be equally yoked with whoever you are engaging in or trying to pursue. Having the same morals and same beliefs with someone is so important. But we need to start applying equally yoked to Christians. Equally yoked does not only apply to non-believers. You can be unequally yoked with Christians. And I think that a lot of us sometimes think that because people are Christians or they label themselves as Christians, we need to be with them. But it's so important that you should align with Christians that match your morals. Both of you guys have to agree that this relationship would do nothing but honor God. I'm going to use this example because this is the biggest sin that lies in courtships or relationships or dating. There are some Christians out here that believe that fornication is okay. I think it's pretty evident that in the Bible that fornication is a sin. So if you're with someone who doesn't believe that, one person's up and the other one's down, it just won't work. Now there's so many things that can hinder you from clearly hearing God, which is sin. And recording with someone, you want to make sure that God is in the center and that you're hearing his voice clearly. If we don't hear the voice of God, we won't be able to hear him clearly concerning the person that you're seeking. I think that it's pretty hard to be able to do the will of God for your relationship to honor God if you're continuously indulging in fornication or any other sin. And we know Jesus is righteous. Each and every day we're striving to be like Jesus and live righteously. So if we're doing things in relationships that go against the will of God, we are not living righteously. So if a relationship doesn't honor God, it's kind of sad to break into you. It won't be accepted by God. It just won't. So I think it's important for us to seek first the kingdom. I think with seeking first the kingdom, that means seeking him in all your ways, seeking him in your decisions, seeking him through guidance, seeking him through directions concerning the person that you're seeking. You need to seek God on who this person is for you, not who you think that person is for you. A man of God is not your man of God. I'm not going to lie that they may be good people. They may be a powerful man of God. They may be a prayerful man of God. They may be everything that you want in a man of God, but they may not be your man of God. And that's why it's so important to seek the will of God, because he will tell you. A lot of times you just simply need to ask and see, God, is this man for me? Is he not? Is this woman for me? Or is she not? It's that simple. A lot of times you tend to overcomplicate what God's capable of. Not seeking God first and making your decisions by yourself is dangerous. Anything or anything you put before God, the knowledge of God, the direction of God, the instructions of God, is a form of idolatry. There's so many different questions that you should ask or bring before God or ask yourself. Is this relationship, is this person strengthening me? What are your genuine intentions when you're dating? Are you dating to get married? Are you dating just for fun? Are you dating just for the vibe? Do I just want a little yeah? Do I just want to just fill it out, see where it goes? Or am I genuinely pursuing this person to get married with them in the near future? If you're in a relationship now, does your relationship honor God? Does it glorify God? Ask yourself, is he proud of your relationship? Are you loving each other right? Am I willing to do the will of God and move how he wants me to move in this relationship and not how I want to move? Ask yourself, is that something that you're willing to do? Because your relationship ultimately is not yours, it's God's. I want to leave you guys also with a prayer point. I think if marriage or dating or whatever is something that you're desiring, ask God to search your heart. Ask him to bring forth whatever it is that may kill your relationship or is killing your relationship with whoever you want to be with. I think that a lot of us genuinely don't understand how mighty and how able God is to move in every aspect of your life, including marriage, including dating. And I think that a lot of us just sometimes need to fully submit that area to God. And I think a lot of us sometimes just don't ask. The Bible says so many times, if only you ask. You don't have because you don't ask. God will provide. We also have to do our part and live righteously. Live according to the will of God. Seek him first. Allow him to be in the center of every relationship. Allow God to be in the middle of it. With him being in the middle of it, there's nothing you can miss, nothing you can do wrong. So seek him, seek first his kingdom, and everything else will be added on. If marriage is not the intention, then singleness is where you need to be. Point blank, period. Thank you for watching this video. It's an honor and it's a pleasure to be here, to be a part of this community, and to share this topic with you guys. And yeah, I'm happy to be a part of this. See you guys later. Bye.